Chris Maylett for BBTV. We're over at Collier & Moston Boxing Gym in Manchester. Pleased to say he bumped into Lee Blundell, former pro, and his young prodigy, Joe Howarth. Nice to see you, lads.
Good to see you.
That was some really good sparring there with Zelfa Barrett. I mean, a great experience for you, Joe, as a young pro. I believe you're only 19. You've got a fight coming up this Saturday. How did it go that for you there, that sparring?
It was all right. Just felt a bit off today.
Yeah, a bit tired today. It's a week away from a fight. Weight's coming down now. Well, he's on weight now, so I'm going in with Zelfa. It's always going to be hard anyway, but it's brilliant experience. Brilliant. Well, you saw with Zelfa himself there, and Elvis did all right, you know. Tipped the boxer, didn't you, kind of?
Yeah. It was nice at the end there, Zelfa speaking to you, you know, a good 10 minutes. He was paying you lots of compliments as well. What was he saying to you there, Zelfa?
I've been punched too many times, mate.
I tell him, keep what he's doing, but add to the game as well.
Yeah.
Little things, little tricks. Mother's Elf is there, isn't he? He's one fight away from a world title. So anything you can take from that, and for him to take his time out and give Joe the bit of time is fantastic. But just little things to add to, because like I said, he'll be coming back. He's not having any rest, Joe. A couple of days off.
Come back in.
Give Zelfa a
Zelfa's camp.
Back again, yeah. So as soon as you get your fight out of the way, you'll be back over here.
Fingers crossed. If no injuries, no troubles, and hopefully he can come straight back down.
Alright, brilliant.
Give him a few more.
So you fight this Saturday?
Next Saturday.
Week tomorrow. Where you fighting? Tell us about the fight and where you fighting.
It's at Reebok Stadium and Jamie Quinn. I'm fighting Jamie Quinn.
Yeah. Right, Jamie knows the game inside out.
Good opponent
for him then, Lee.
Very, very good opponent. Brings all the tricks, knows everything. Been in with everybody, including himself. Yeah, he's done it with them all. So if you're going to tick a box, you've got to tick it with Jamie Quinn, because he's seasoned. He's one of the best out there now, in the game. So if you're going to fight him, get it done early.
Well, your second fight you're going in with him there, so fair play to you. I mean, Jamie's a sort of fighter as well. You know, if you've got a couple of chinks on the night, or you're off a bit, you're like...
Yeah. Well, on my debut, he won, didn't he?
He fought
on the same show and won. So
he boxed a lad making his debut, and he won quite a couple of games, and he'll do that.
I mean, watching you today, I wouldn't have thought you was a 19-year-old who'd had one pro fight. You look really, really good. So what your background in boxing then? Lee told me a little bit there, you've not had much experience. Can you tell us how you got into it and what you've done?
Well, I played rugby from 5, and I got bored of it when I was 12, and my 13th birthday I come down to the gym, and since then I've not stopped.
Right, and just took it from there. I believe you had you didn't do any amateur experience, you've gone straight into the pros.
Yeah. Did the white collar.
Did a few white collars, didn't we?
13, training adults, because it was the time he could get into the gym, he couldn't get down earlier. His dad would bring him in, so he had training adults. So he's always been the littlest kid in gym, in classes, and he's always done sparring with big uns and adults, and it's worked for him. It's worked for everybody, just chucking him straight in the deep end. But he was a tough, rough, ready, fit kid anyway.
It's alright, Tom, go on. It's only Thomas McDonough, he can get away with anything like that.
It just worked for him and he went from there as a kid straight through.
How's your gym doing, Lee?
Mad busy as always. So we've got loads. We was here last night, brought my son, who helps me with it, and a few of the other coaches. He came up here with about 7, 8, 9 kids last night for some sparring. I could have spent 20 kids up, really. It's that busy. Since with the lockdown, I think a lot of kids have realised how important getting out and exercise and doing stuff is. So we've gone mad again now, we've gone busy. Same with the adult class, we've got loads of kids coming through. We've got some really good, exciting kids, just like Joe, coming through on the same thing. They all do the same as Joe and the lads before him, and Lennox, and one other kid, come through with him at the same time. And they're all doing the same, ticking the same boxes, sparring, going to the same gyms, getting the experiences in places like this. When you say we're going to Collier & Moston, everybody knows Collier & Moston. It's one of them gyms. It's an iconic gym, isn't it, from way back when. So when they talk kids, and the kids who know the boxing, which a lot of my kids, I'm going. So they come away. Even parents, can we drive? It's great. So we get them out and get them training, get them fighting as much as possible. But experience, and even if they don't want to fight, they're training, they're in the gym, they're mixing, and you know, it's like a great big family. We can have like 40 kids, 40 adults in the night, and everybody knows everybody, and they all train, they all help each other out. Joe mixes with all kids and helps all the kids out. So it's really good. And that's where the tickets, the support, because you're helping all the kids. They see you doing.
Everyone
kids,
comes from gym,
and everybody comes from gym. Then they all have, support, you know, yeah. And they all support each other because it's
good. Lot, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a really good group of people. Though, so, and they all help out. Like I said last night, I had umpteen people said, "I'll drive, I'll come." Obviously, if I come here, they thought they weren't, you know. But it's brilliant. So, and then we're here again. We've been here this week. I was up all of them yesterday with somebody else sparring at Stubby's gym. So. Busy, but
go everywhere, good. Don't we?
Everywhere, we like, yeah, everywhere.
You go back with Pat and Tommy as well, don't you?
Right? Oh yeah, Tommy. Yeah. I used to train here all the time. And when Brian was here,
yeah.
Luckily, Brian, I didn't say too much, but he'd let me come all the time, so I was always here. So when Mikey Gomez was here, Jennings, all the lads, Robbie, everybody there. So I was lucky.
Sparred a few times in that ring
so,
yourself.
Yeah, that exactly the same. When I come back with lads. And it hadn't changed, it just took me straight back to them. Yeah. And it's the atmosphere, everything's exactly the same.
Yeah.
So welcoming, but so scary for the first time to come in.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
And this man walking through the door now, he's exactly the same.
Yeah,
cracker. Okay. So it runs a belt in, runs a good shape, Ben does. Looked after my kids last night.
Yeah.
And as you've just seen
some
there,
top
puts
kids
the lad,
there.
Yeah, puts
like
some
really
some
good kids coming through.
Like you, Lee, Ben's you know, gone from the boxing,
to
now
the
he's
yeah.
Coaching, so it was like a natural progression for you.
Yeah. I was off for a while, I was like, because I was ill for a while, I couldn't do nothing for a bit, and then I found my feet again once I got back, and since I started coaching in seven, 8 years ago, I've never looked back, and it's brilliant.
How long have you not had a day off for?
Yeah.
How long have you not had a day off for?
I have loads of days off. So, but people like him and Lennox and the kids at Jim Alfie and Isaacs and all them lot. They make you want to go to work because you see them and you know this when they come to gym they live it and they're kids 11, 12 year old with attitudes like professionals and it's unbelievable. But that's because they're training with about yourself. They're seeing what he's doing and they say I have to do that. They're seeing Joey all fly gear on and they're all there, kids 10, 11 year old with fly gear on in gym. I never all my gear out together never cost as much a pair of gear.
Well, you've been there a few years now, haven't you? You're an old head there. So it's like a family unit, is it? Like you say now that you all support each other. You take some of the younger lads under your wing as well, and it's like a family unit. Most boxing gyms are like that.
Yeah.
That's good.
Good.
Tell
us about
the people worry about boxing clubs, but the inside once you get them into the gym, the kids grow and that's it, isn't it? Come on so much with kids.
Yeah. Well, everyone's coming in here, aren't they, in the dressing room, so I know you've got to get off, but I thought I'd have a quick catch up with you anyway while you
really
was here and talk about your fight. Just remind us again about the fight and how anyone can get tickets and that kind of thing, Joe.
Next Saturday, Bolton at Reebok.
Next Saturday,
yeah.
Bolton.
Have you got all the, what do you call it, Instagrams and everything?
Yeah, what Instagram?
Tell us that then.
Joe Howarth, double H at the end.
Right, I'll stick it on the screen.
There's three from our gym. We've got Joe, Lennox.
Lennox and Dan Booth.
And Dan Booth, all fighting on the same show, from our gym. So, and it's good build. Some other good kids on it as well.
I know when we're still doing an interview and you pulled him, he went, oh no, not a little bit.
How come not that speaking?
Well, you got to get used to it for when you're a champion, haven't you? So, a bit of learning for you there. So, if you can do it here with me, and you'll be all right. So. Anyway, it's great to catch up with you, like I say, and good luck on Saturday next Saturday, and I'm sure I'll catch up with you along the way. I'll bob down to the gym, Lee, and
That'd
see
be
you.
Fantastic, mate, yeah.
Yeah, see some of the other prospects you've got coming through.
Yep.
Have a good day, God bless.
And you,
mate,
thank you.
Again, Saturday, so
couple of days off,
back on.
Yeah.
So keep learning.